The major update from last week was the Prime Minister's visit to the Taupo electorate. It was a fantastic visit, a bit of a whirlwind as per usual. And the first thing that we did on Thursday morning was went out to GNS. I wanted the Prime Minister to meet the scientists involved in the critical work and monitoring that's been done since the Canterbury earthquake in September and of course the more recent one in February. So it was great to be able to get an update from them on the work they're doing. We also had a visit to Tenon. Tenon is the largest employer in Taupo. Had a fantastic visit, got to really see the work they're doing and the products that they export overseas. A very significant operation and great to see their use of technology bringing export dollars, much needed export dollars, into New Zealand. The meeting over lunch was with the part of the large herds conference that was based on a farm just outside Taupo, and the Prime Minister was able to speak to the farmers there. The thing that fascinated me the most was the range of questions that they asked of him, and it was great to see so many there in what was a chilly time in a wool shed. From there we went to the Somerset Retirement Village, and the Prime Minister opened some of the new apartments there. Great complex, absolutely fantastic complex, and so he was able to cut the ribbon there and talk to some of the residents in the village. He then had to fly back to Wellington at short notice, and I had a women's meeting that focused on issues around health and education, and it was a really great discussion around how we can better solve some of the problems in terms of agencies, both non-government and government organisations, working together better. And so similar to what we've done in the maternity area in Taupo, we're looking at what else we can do by working together to meet the community's needs. The weekend was a massive weekend for Taupo with the Oxfam Trail Walker. Great to see the number of people out and about, 260 teams. And the update that I had from the manager there was fundraising was over $600,000. So massive effort for those walking 100 kilometres for Oxfam. Sunday was the funeral of Roger Kirk, a man that many, many people in the Taupo community knew and respected. And it was a very large service, one that would have done him proud. And he'll be missed terribly. This week I'm going to be focusing during this sitting of Parliament on the Canterbury legislation that's going through the House this week. I'm on the Local Government and Environment Select Committee, so that's going to be a big priority. Other big news locally has been the drop in crime that's come out. The statistics have come out recently, and Taupo stands out as one of the areas that's had a significant drop in crime, over 6%. So the Taupo police have been doing a stunning job, and I wanted to pass on my gratitude for everything they're doing. Other than that, we've got Easter coming up, and of course the Easter Monday will be Anzac Day. Just wanted to wish you a very happy Easter, safe travelling if you're out and about. And if you're moving out of the district, just travelling out of the district, please make sure that you drive safely and have fun over the school holidays.